Yo, what's up? I'm Adam.
I'm Patrick.
And in this video, Patrick's got to help me out because I've been hearing all about this Copilot for Power BI thing, and it's not out yet, but Patrick said it was.
Yeah, it's out, my friend. It's out. And I want to show you. I want to show you what it is.
All right. And to be clear, this is that nice video I saw, right? That's what you're going to go through, right?
Wait a minute.
That's my expectation.
You're going too far, my friend. I got to rein you in a little bit. I got to rein you in a little bit. There's lots of Copilots. Microsoft's introducing lots of Copilots, and there's one in the desktop. Enough of all this talking, Adam. Let's head over to my machine, my friend.
All right.
So there's a couple of ways to get to this Copilot, and I'm so excited about it, Adam. You can click right here. You can choose quick measures. What does it say right there, Adam? What does it say?
Oh, it says Copilot.
Or if you close the pane and you go to your data and you right click on the table, you can choose new quick measure. And it's there also. So the quick measure has been there for a very long time. And you can choose a calculation. I think they had some templates. Remember, a long time ago, they wanted people to submit templates. But now we got Copilot.
So I can just tell it what I want, and it's going to magically write the DAX. So I don't need Marco anymore.
I don't know about that.
Okay, not going that far.
Let me show you how this works. So with quick measures, you would click the drop down. You could choose it and walk through a little template. I don't want to use templates. So I'm just going to type something in. I'm going to say show total sales because I want to see sales from last year. So notice how it picks up my measures, you know, the attributes, the measures in the columns.
This is like the Q&A thing where it kind of auto completes.
Yeah. So show total sales amount for last year. And I'm going to go ahead and click generate.
Wow.
Look how fast that was. Let's take a look at this code. Look at that. Same period last year. I would say this is not bad DAX.
And that worked also the same period last year because we have a central calendar table.
Yes.
And that's allowing us to do the time intelligence. Yeah. But Patrick, I have a scenario. I need to do it by a specific country. Can it do that?
Yeah. Okay. Let's do that. And where country is Canada?
All right. Generate.
There we go, Adam. There we go.
Wait
a minute.
What is that plus? It's like a union.
Oh, it's adding. So it's saying I'm going to get the sales for last year.
That's not good.
The sales for Canada.
That's not what I want.
So we got to fix this. This lends itself to a point that you made earlier when we were talking about Copilots and stuff like that. You got to know your data.
And the main thing there is like when you're typing these things out, it's like when you go to the internet search engine of your choice and you're typing in things and then you get weird results, right? You got to think about what you're typing and give it some hints about what you want.
Let's say show total sales amount for last year. Let's get rid of this.
I think that and was.
Let's get rid of this. Where country is Canada? Let's go ahead and generate. Let's go ahead and generate again.
Wait. I do know my model, Patrick, and it picked the wrong table.
That's okay.
It doesn't work.
No. It works. I know what the problem is. You said you know your model. I took a peek at the model.
Okay.
There's a country and there's a sales country. Let's see if we fix this. I'm going to say sales country. Look at that. It highlighted it.
Oh.
I'm going to go ahead and choose generate.
That's it. All right.
Copilot to the rescue. Now I can click add this to my model and I can start using it. This answers your question. How much DAX did I write?
It was a journey to get to the right DAX.
Yeah, but you didn't write any. Absolutely.
DAX. When you're looking at these, this is the key point too, is don't just trust what it creates, right? You got to validate that and make sure, you know, kind of spot check it.
If you go look at the pane, it even says at the top, suggested measure. It's just a suggestion. It says, maybe I'm close. Maybe this is spot on, but, you know, definitely go validate.
I want to try this and I want you to, I want you to make sure that I can do this right. Okay. All right.
Okay.
So let's head over to my machine. I'm going to go over to internet sales. I'm just going to right click on it and say new quick measure, right? This is it. Wait.
I feel like I'm being set up.
And this is not what I saw on your machine.
Go helping about.
Helping about.
What's your version?
I'm on the latest July build of desktop.
Go to your preview features.
Yes. I think you're right, my friend. Ah, look at that. I didn't include quick measures. So as of the recording of this video, it's still a preview feature. So enable that if you want to play around with this. All right. What do you guys think? Is this something you've tried? Is it something you're like getting success with? Like, let us know in the comments below. We'd love to hear it. Also, if you are interested in more great videos from Guy in a Cube, check out the suggested video up above. We'd love you to go watch that. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome. And we'll see you in the next video.